Hello, in this video you will learn how to escape a privileged Docker container. Before I understood how Docker containers work, I thought they are insanely complicated. They are surely not easy, but they are also not that hard. This video will give you an idea about it. The episode is based on a blog post by Disconnected from Trail of Beats. He's also my friend and he hugely helped me to start my cybersecurity career, so make sure to give him a follow. Links, as always, are in the description. Enjoy! Docker containers are somewhat similar to virtual machines. Each one is better for different use cases. The difference is, among others, that VMs virtualize the hardware and have separate kernel. Containers, on the other hand, are much lighter. On the lower level, they are just processes isolated from the rest of the system. It has many benefits when you want to create an application. For example, the container will be much lighter than the VM and much easier to deploy. However, from the security point of view, it is more risky because there is less isolation between the container and the host operating system. It is possible to configure your container securely. Then, even if you would have an RCE in the web app that's inside the container, the attacker wouldn't be able to escalate his privileges to the host machine. However, creating a secure container is not trivial. Often, the easiest way to solve some problem is by giving the container additional privileges. In today's episode, you will see how easy it is to escape a container that has too much permissions. Keep in mind, I am not showing you a Docker vulnerability that only works in outdated versions. It's a repeatable way to escape the container with specific privileges in the newest version of Docker. Precisely, we need to run in the container as root user and we need the ability to use the mount command. Let's start by explaining control groups or just C groups. It's a Linux feature that allows grouping processes and limiting resources like CPU time of those groups. It's also one of mechanisms with which Docker isolates processes inside the container from those of the host. And there is a feature that allows to execute a specific command once all processes in the C group are terminated. For example, this can be used to notify the kernel that all processes in the C group are terminated and the group can be removed. This is the feature that will be exploited to escape the container because this command will be executed on the host. Let's jump to the exploit and explain it step by step. So we start an Ubuntu container. These are the insecure options that will allow us to use the mount command. Capad is for adding capabilities. Now what are capabilities? Before them, each process would be either non-privileged, subject to all permission checks, or privileged, effectively run as root, bypassing all kernel permission checks. Capabilities divide those privileges and allow more granular granting. For example, chown capability allows changing file's owner, while kill capability allows sending any signals. Sysadmin is a very powerful capability which will give us the ability to use the mount syscall. Deciding on granting or restricting each capability upon creation of a new container would be very time-consuming. This problem is partially solved by AppArmor. Among other things, AppArmor can specify a list of restricted capabilities. This command turns off Docker default AppArmor profile because it restricts the sysadmin capability which we need. Running this command gives us a shell inside the container, and our goal is to execute a command on the host. The first step of the exploit is creating a new C group and, using mount command, telling the system where are the files that describe this C group. Because in practice, C group is just a bunch of files, and this is its structure. There is one file particularly interesting for us, notify on release. When the value inside this file is zero, nothing happens when all processes from the C group are terminated. However, when the value is 1, upon terminating all processes, a command from release agent file from upper directory is executed. So in our exploit, we put the value 1 inside the notify on release file in our C group. The command that we will want to execute will be put in the /cmd file inside the container. If our attack will be successful, this file will be executed by the host. However, if we run /cmd on the host, there will be no such file error, because the host won't know that this file is inside the container. And obviously, being in the container, we can't just write a file on the host operating system. So we need to find under what path files from inside the container are reachable on the host. For this, we need to look in the etc/mtap file, and we'll use a handy regex to extract this path. Next, we put this path inside the release agent file. Then, we put our commands that will be executed on the host inside the cmd file. In this case, we'll just list processes of the host and put the result in the output file inside the container so we can read it later. So for this whole thing to be triggered, all processes from the C group must be terminated. But there are no processes in the C group yet. To add process to the C group, we need to put its process ID inside the C group process file. So we create a new process, and all it does is putting its PID inside this C group process file. $ is a special bash variable that contains each process own ID. And the process is terminated just after doing that. And that's the moment that the release agent is executed. And in this case, the release agent is our cmd file. So on the host, the ps command is executed and the result is put into the output file inside the container. We can then cut this file and see the result, which proves that the attack was successful and we were able to escape the container. To prevent such attack from happening, when creating a Docker container, always remember to avoid using privileged flag, because it basically gives the container full access to the host. Also, never mount Docker socket inside the container, because then the attacker would be able to create a new privileged container himself and use this technique. And also, never run as root inside the container, because it opens a lot of potential attack vectors to escalate privileges. Because keep in mind that the root inside the container is not some different root. By default, it's exactly the same user as root on the host. I hope that after watching the video, you understand container escapes a little bit better. If you do, support the channel by leaving a like, or maybe even buying me a coffee. Also, sign up for my mailing list to not miss any of my videos or other products. Anyway, for now, thanks for watching and goodbye.